Mother, Mother Ocean, I have heard you call. Wanted to sail upon your waters since I was 3 feet tall. You seen it all. You seen it all. Watch the man.
Mommy once told me that it's one thing to know the way forward, but you also need to have the will, the courage to do it. And that's much harder. Suzanne lived her own adage to the fullest. She is courageous, joyous, authentic, compassionate, and genuine. She could connect with anyone. Agree or disagree with her politics, you'll likely end up friends with Suzanne anyway. She has dear friends here and from every end of the spectrum and in between. I've heard many stories lately and hopefully many more to come about laughing all night in the hot tub with or without clothes, and cracking up over card games or puzzles or trivia. Let it be known that team Better Off Without Him usually won the halftime wildcard question, even if not much else. Suzanne definitely knew how to have a good time. And in tandem, she always stuck by her word as a fierce advocate for equity and justice in human rights and women's equality. This is a vivid memory for my friends and I growing up. My mom had the party house. Of course, you're not surprised. We could do whatever we wanted, and Suzanne was always cool. The only time she ever intervened, and she could seriously put people in their place, I know you know what I mean. The only time she intervened was when she heard a racial stereotype about immigrants in Northwest Arkansas. Mom stepped in and made it very clear that all people are created equal and welcome in this house, that only by difference of circumstance and hate, fear, are we separated. And who is the one holding the hate or fear in those stereotypic racist remarks? She was one of the first women to live in Pomfret dormitories at the University of Arkansas, where she defiantly wore slacks under her trench coat instead of the sexist skirts only dress code at the time. When I was applying to the University of Arkansas, I asked, "Mom, were you in a sorority?" And she shouted, "Hell no, I burned my bra so you didn't have to do that shit." Suzanne led an incredible life. She touched many more people in many more spheres than I can name. However, I can say for sure that each person she encountered, she valued their story and their experience dearly. Your story and your experience. One morning on the way to 6 a.m. figure skating, not her favorite mom errand, she picked up a man hitchhiking and we drove him to his workplace. When I asked why she did that, she said she just got the sense that she could trust him and that we were all just one incident away from tough circumstances. When I was younger, I used to get so frustrated about the newspaper pile on the floor and the empty Diet Coke cans. And then one day, a work colleague of hers told me that she was the most organized and thorough, effective person she'd ever worked with. My mom had an amazing capacity to make the most out of every situation. She juggled more than her fair share of challenges with breast cancer and heartache and glass ceilings, yet she was always calm, cool, and collected. Somehow she always had hope and faith in the universe that things would work out, and they did. She lived her best life always. I know she was her happiest pink, purple, blue hair and fancy nails self here. My mom would never let me stand here and tell you that she was perfect. What she was, and her legacy will continue to be, is an incredible learner, a leader by example. She learned from every mistake, from every success, and she lived with such integrity that every next step was more meaningful than the last. She learned from everyone she knew, from living in Nebraska, to Alaska, to Tokyo, to London, to Iran, to Arkansas, to California, to Arkansas again, and Ecuador, where she was living her best life. She was a psychologist in the women's prison in Pine Bluff, Arkansas, an aide to Governor Bill Clinton, the CEO of the Levi Strauss Charitable Foundation. She put them on the map, and she was one of San Francisco's most eligible bachelorettes. She was the director of the Jones Foundation in Springdale, where she advocated for police accountability, international baccalaureate schools in marginalized communities, and universal healthcare clinics in schools. When she helped dedicate Turnbull Elementary School, she was the only speaker who talked to the kids rather than just offenders. She loved being the director of development for Circle of Life Hospice and of Life here in Springdale and Kansas City, where she said the optimism and joy was unfathomable. She ran a Cuenca consignment store with friends in Cuenca, Ecuador, and she had the most fun building community here in Cuenca. She's a sister, a friend, a chosen family mom, a cat mom, a fourth grade classroom mom, and the most incredible mom I could ever imagine. Suzanne leaves us with laughter and celebration and joy and accountability, along with other great advice, like put extra face cream on the back of your hand so you can always be whatever age you want, and quality over quantity. This especially applies to shopping, unless it's shoe shopping, in which case quality and quantity. You all know many more sides of Suzanne and more anecdotes of her greatness. One of her superpowers is building community. I hope you hear more of these great anecdotes of her greatness from you all too. You all, this incredible community of friends and family surrounding Suzanne who love her so much and who she loves so much, this is a testament to her legacy. I've said plenty of times to plenty of people and many more to come that my mom is the ultimate badass. If I can be a fraction of the incredible, courageous friend and leader that she is, I will continue to do the world justice in her legacy. A few things I am certain, and without a doubt, the world is a better place for Suzanne Marie Ward's impact.
Thank you.